We expect that the overall passenger vehicle volume growth would be in the range of 6-9% for FY17. Our growth expectation is driven by a falling cost of ownership of passenger vehicles as well as an improvement in purchasing power of households. A fall in fuel prices as well as a decline in interest rates is likely to increase affordability of passenger vehicles. There has been a steady decline in petrol and diesel prices over the past 2 years. This has actually reduced the running cost of vehicles, and the expectation is that there won't be any recovery in fuel prices in FY17. This is likely to help the demand for passenger vehicles. Interest costs have also steadily declined over the past 2 years. As a result, most banks have declined their base rates, which are reflected in declining interest rates on PV loans. This has also increased the affordability of passenger vehicles. Now, another important point is the purchasing power of households. This is likely to improve as disposable incomes would be positively impacted in FY17, not just by higher GDP growth, but also by increase in salaries for government employees based on the recommendation of 7th Central Pay Commission. Now, if you see FY15 RBI data on aggregate household assets and liabilities, there has been a greater decline in household liabilities than the decline in household assets. This is also beneficial for automotive demand in the next 1 to 2 years, as buyers would be in a position to avail debt for the purchase of new vehicles. We expect medium and heavy commercial vehicle segment volume to grow at 12-15% in FY17. This is lower than the growth rate of around 30% witnessed during 9-month FY16 period due to the tapering off of replacement demand. Now, based on our interaction with auto OEMs, we believe that the strong growth seen in FY15 and FY16 in this segment was partly attributed to the replacement of old vehicles by large fleet operators. Now, in FY13 and 14, fleet operators had delayed the replacement of their old vehicles beyond the normal term of 5 to 7 years, given the weak industrial demand for freight. While the low industrial demand has continued, this significant lowering of diesel prices has positively impacted the profitability of fleet operators, prompting them to use the additional cash flow for fleet replacement. One more point is that the improvement in MHCV sales volume till September 2015 could also be attributed to preemptive purchases on account of price increases due to the mandatory adoption of anti-skid braking system by all CV manufacturers. After September 2015, if you see, there has been a steep drop in MHCV volumes. This factor also leads us to believe that the growth rate in this category in FY17 would be lower than that in FY16. Majority of these OEMs are net debt negative, while in the case of foreign players, credit profile is also supported from overseas parents. We expect that these companies should be able to sustain their credit profile in FY16 and 17 due to improved profitability. This, along with their current low leverage, means that despite significant capex planned in the PV segment in FY17, wherein the industry capacity is expected to increase by 0.5 million units to around 6.6 million units, the financial profiles of players will not be affected.